رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. We will continue with the second part of the brief explanation of the 30th para with Surah Al-Balad. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Balad, which was revealed during the third phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stay in Makkah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 4, "We have certainly created man into hardship." It means that this world is not a place of rest and ease for man, but it is a place of labor and hardship. And no man can escape this harsh reality. Even if he is a king or a dictator, he can never really have internal peace from the fear that a rebellion might rise against him somewhere. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 6, He says, "I have spent wealth in abundance." This is a man who is boasting and telling others how he spends his wealth. We also see people like this around us, right? Surah Ash-Shams. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Ash-Shams, which was revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The central subject of this surah is about the human conscience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 9 and 10, "The one who purifies his soul succeeds, and the one who corrupts it fails." Your conscience is the part of your mind that tells you if what you are doing is wrong. This conscience is inbuilt in all of us. The person who listens to it and cleans his inner self succeeds. And on the other hand, the person who repeatedly and knowingly does wrong and doesn't listen to his conscience, that person's conscience goes into the sleep mode. Surah Al-Layl. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Layl, which was revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The central subject of this surah is given in verse 4, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Indeed, your efforts are diverse." Everyone is making an effort, right? But the efforts of each individual are different. Some of us are working for the eternal happiness of the hereafter, while others are busy in making their paradise in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us example of both types of people. There is one who gives his charity and fears Allah and believes in the best reward, and another who is a miser and considers himself free of need. Both will have different results. Surah Az-Zuha. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Az-Zuha, which was revealed during the first phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The surah was revealed during the time when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had not received any revelation for a long period of time. The surah was sent to console and help Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to overcome his anxiety. It has the power to heal the heart and give hope to its reader. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verses 4 and 5, "And the next life is certainly far better for you than this one. And surely your Lord will give you so much so that you will be pleased." Isn't this the best thing to hear when you are depressed and fed up with this worldly life? That your next life is going to be better than this one in every way? So strive for that world and leave the problems of this world to your Lord. Surah Al-Nashra. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Nashra, which was revealed during the first phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The surah provides reassurance and comfort to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and emphasizes the fact that after hardship comes ease. How can we find that ease? By devoting our free time to prayers and by building a stronger connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah At-Teen. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah At-Teen, which was revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. This surah tells us that man was created in the best image and form and was given a special status among all other creations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 4 and 5, "We have indeed created man in the best of molds, then we reduced him to the lowest of the low." See how there is no concept of body shaming in Islam? We have all been created perfectly by our Lord, but this perfect man can sometimes stoop so low and commit such actions which make him worse than animals. Surah Al-Alaq. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Alaq. The first revelation sent to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were the first 5 verses of this surah. The surah starts with a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to read. This signifies the importance of reading and learning. The second part of this surah refers to the hardship faced by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in following the deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 9 and 10, "Have you seen him who prevents a servant when he prays? These verses were about Abu Jahl, who threatened Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for performing the prayers at the Kaaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns Abu Jahl and all other such people who stop others from obeying their Lord of a severe punishment. Surah Al-Qadr. Let's take a look at the flowchart of microstructure which was revealed during the first phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The central subject of this surah is Laylatul Qadr, or the night of power. We are told that the Quran was revealed on Laylatul Qadr. This book is so valuable that it couldn't be said on an ordinary date. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 1, we sent it down in the night of destiny. It is the night during which destinies are decided. It's a night of unique honor, dignity and glory, so much so that it is better than 1,000 months. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to get the most benefit of this night. Ameen. Surah Al-Bayyinah. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Bayyinah, which was revealed in Makkah. This surah is one of the last two surahs revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam before his death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained in this surah why it was necessary to send a messenger along with the holy book. Now that the last prophet has arrived with clear proof of his prophethood and the last message, the holy Quran, is also here, if people still refuse to acknowledge this religion, then they are the worst of creatures. And the people who would believe and act righteously are the best of creatures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about these blessed people in verse 8, Allah is well pleased with them and they are well pleased with Him. All this is for him who fears his Lord. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among such people. Ameen. Surah Az-Zilzal, Surah Al-Adiyat, Surah Al-Kariyah. All three surahs were revealed during the first stage of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Az-Zilzal. Its central subject is that man will be shown his good and bad deeds on the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 7 and 8, so whoever does an atom's weight of good will see it, and whoever does an atom's weight of evil will see it. Let's look at Surah Al-Adiyat. Its central subject is that even though all the other creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are loyal to Him, it is only man that is ungrateful to his Creator. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 6, indeed mankind to his Lord is ungrateful. Let's take a look at the flow chart of Surah Al-Kariyah. Its central subject is that the abundance of good deeds in the weighing scale on the day of judgment will be the cause of entry into paradise, and the shortage of good deeds will cause entry into the hellfire. To give a glimpse of day of judgment, called the great calamity in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is the day people will be like scattered moths and the mountains will be like carded wool. Surah At-Takasur. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah At-Takasur, which was revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. The central subject of this surah is to avoid the worship of this world and avoid piling up wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse 1, the piling up of worldly things diverts you. This means that the desire to get more and more wealth keeps us so busy and distracted that we don't get time to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the end result is that we forget the purpose of our creation. Surah Al-Asr, Surah Al-Humaza, Surah Al-Fil, Surah Al-Quraysh. All four of these surahs were revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. Let's look at Surah Al-Asr, which highlights the importance of time. We are told that our time on this earth is limited, so we are ordered to do these four things as soon as possible. Number 1, become a believer. Number 2, do righteous deeds. Number 3, remind others of the truth. And number 4, remind others to be patient. Let's now look at Surah Al-Humaza. The surah talks about the one who slaps others. They do this because of the pride of their wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verses 2 and 3, who collects wealth and continuously counts it. He thinks that his wealth will make him immortal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he will be thrown into Al-Hutama, which is one of the descriptive names of hellfire. It describes hell as being a place which will crush and break to pieces whatever is thrown into it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from this place. Ameen. Surah Al-Fil gives the lesson from the end of Abraha. Abraha was the ruler of Yemen who had come to destroy the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the Kaaba and destroyed his powerful army and huge elephants with tiny birds. Surah Al-Quraysh mentions two of the biggest blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, food and hunger, and security in the time of fear. The Quraysh were also told in this surah to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for making them the custodians of the Kaaba. Kaaba was the reason why Quraysh had superiority over other tribes, and also the reason for many of their economic and trade benefits. Surah Al-Ma'un, Surah Al-Kawthar, and Surah Al-Kafirun. These surahs were revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. Surah Al-Ma'un talks about the kind of personality a person develops when he refuses to believe in the hereafter. When there is no sense of accountability, a person does only what benefits his own self. Even if that person prays, it is only to show off. That person repels the orphans, does not feed the poor, and refrains from doing even the small acts of kindness. Surah Al-Kawthar give the good news to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including the reservoir of Kawthar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then orders Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and us to express gratitude to him by praying to him and by sacrificing the things that we love for his sake. Surah Al-Kafirun is a command to not worship anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders us to proclaim to everyone in verse 6, to you is your religion and to me my religion. Meaning our lifestyle, our dress code, our manners should all show that we are Muslims. Surah Al-Nasr. It is the first complete surah sent to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam before his death in Medina. This was the time when Islam had attained complete victory in Arabia and people had started entering Islam in great numbers. It meant that the mission for which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had been sent to the world had been fulfilled. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had spent 23 years of his life in hardship to complete this task. Yet when he had done this huge accomplishment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to praise him and to pray for his forgiveness. This also teaching us that when we accomplish something, instead of boasting, we should also ask for forgiveness and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Lahab, Surah Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Falak, and Surah An-Nas. These surahs were revealed during the second phase of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's stay in Makkah. Let's take a look at the flow chart of microstructure of Surah Al-Lahab. This is the only place in the Quran where a person from among the enemies of Islam has been condemned by name. Why was this person named? Because he was the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His father and Abu Lahab were real brothers. In Arabia, an uncle represented the father, especially when the nephew was fatherless. But Abu Lahab and his wife became one of the biggest enemies. This surah gives them the news that they will go to hell. Surah Al-Ikhlas deals exclusively with Tawheed. Whoever understands it and believes in its teachings will get rid of shirk completely. Whenever people question Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he replied by the words of this surah, because this surah is the best description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Falak and Surah Nas are two powerful surahs and are collectively called the Mawzatain, meaning the verses of refuge. These surahs were revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam during a time when his health was slightly affected by witchcraft or black magic. These surahs teach us to seek refuge in the only one who can actually protect us. A believer should trust only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and should not take the refuge of anyone else, even his own self. In Surah Al-Falak, we seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's protection from the evil of external calamities and from the evil of the darkness of the night. For most of the crimes and act of wickedness are committed at night. Then we ask for protection against magic and also from the evil of envy. Then in Surah Nas, we seek protection from the evil of our own selves, and the source of all those shortcomings is the whispering of the shaitan. We know from ahadith that whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to bed at night, he used to cup his hands together and blow over them after reciting Surah Al-Ikhlas, Surah Al-Falak, and Surah An-Nas, and then rub his hands over whatever parts of his body he was able to rub. Alhamdulillah, we have reached the end of the Quran for now, because inshallah we will pick from where we end today, as the study of this book should be a lifelong passion for all of us. Let's get to the question I'm going to ask myself. And today the questions are going to be more than one. The questions are, am I ready to practically implement the teachings of Islam in my life? Have I recognized what I need to change in my life to be a better Muslim? Have I started to plan my roadmap to paradise? Answer these questions before Ramzan ends and plan for your eternal happiness. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you steadfast and choose the people who will help you on your journey, because shaitan will try to get you away from the right path, and we will need a strong support group to battle the temptations of the dunya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts and make us the best version of ourselves. Ameen.